Everyone, welcome to our channel Current Affairs for You. So today we will discuss the important things. So first one, who has won the United Nations Global Climate Action Award 2020? So the options are National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, Greta Thunberg, Global Himalayan Expedition, Greenpeace. So the answer for this question is Global Himalayan Expedition. United Nations Climate Change Executive Secretary Patricia Espinosa. He is the executive secretary, Patricia Espinosa. Global Himalayan Expedition GHE brought solar energy to remote communities. Why this particular Global Himalayan Expedition won this award for 2020? Because it brought solar energy to remote communities, means the places where the normal people, it's like a tribal people live. It's a remote area where the facilities are not up to the mark. So the Global Himalayan Expedition went there and they did solar energy for the communities who stay there. Almost around 131 villages have been electrified by using solar energy and directly impacting the lives of more than 60,000 villagers. Almost around 60,000 villagers have been given solar electricity. That's why GHE Global Himalayan Expedition won this award for 2020. So this is a prestigious award, you should remember. And the second one, which of the following nation offered F-18 naval fighter jets to the Indian Navy? So this is about F-18. Recently, Rafael jets brought by India from France. And now we are discussing about F-18. Which of the following nation offered F-18 naval fighter jets to the Indian Navy? So options for you, France, USA, UAE, Russia. So the answer for this is USA. So currently, there is something called 2+2 dialogue between India and United States of America. So the US government has offered to sell their F-18 fighters along with the unnamed aircraft Sea Guardian to the Indian Navy. So the Indian Navy had a few years ago expressed interest in the acquisition of 57 naval fighter aircraft for operations from its aircraft carriers, including the present INS Vikramaditya. So INS Vikramaditya is very much important for India. It is a very huge one. From this, there is on this INS Vikramaditya ship, lot of aircrafts, air jets will be landed, and whenever it is needed, from there they will launch. So now India already shown their interest to buy almost 57 naval fighter, and now US, United States of America is ready to sell F-18 fighters. These are naval fighting aircrafts. So India is ready now. And next question, when do we celebrate International Animation Day? So recently we celebrated Audio Visual Day also, that is 27th October, and also World Polio Day, that is 24th October. And also on 24th October we will celebrate one more thing, is United Nations organization. So United Nations also started on that day, 24th October. And the answer for this question is October 28th. So we celebrate International Animation Day on October 28th every year. So October 28th is celebrated as International Animation Day. It recognizes the artists, the scientists and the technicians behind the animated art, including animated movies. So whenever we watch any animation movie, we only appreciate the movie. But this particular day, we will remember the persons behind the screen. So the next question is, which state has become the first to fix MSP for vegetables, minimum selling price? So it is the state Kerala. The correct answer is Kerala. Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan announced that from Tuesday, the floor price, it means government will set a basic price to sell the vegetables, and this is done by Kerala, and this is the first country to do so, and the Kerala governor is Arif Muhammad Khan. In which of the following city Commanders Conference of Indian Army was held? So it is our national capital, it is Delhi. So Commanders Conference of Indian Army was held at Delhi, and it is a 4-day conference. Present Chief of Indian Army is General Manoj Mukund Naravane. Recently he commissioned INS Kavarati at Visakhapatnam port, and Chief of Naval Staff Admiral Karambir Singh, and Air Chief Marshal is Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria. And when do we celebrate Air Force Day? October 8th. When do we celebrate Army Day? January 15th. And when do we celebrate Navy Day? December 4th. So these are some of the important points about Indian Army, Air Force and Navy. And the next, Luis Acre has been elected as the new president of which of the following country? Bolivia, Peru, Argentina, Venezuela. So the option for this question, correct answer is Bolivia. And the capitals, there are two capitals for Bolivia. One is Sucre and the second one is La Paz. And it is a country which lies in South America, in the continent of South America. So now who is the new president of Bolivia? Luis Acre. Arce. Next, there are some important news. A young boy from Bangladesh won a prize. What is the prize and why did he won the prize? Who conducted that competition? Let's know. So the name of the boy is Anzar Mustain Ali. He is from Bangladesh and is very much young to win this prize. And this competition conducted by Indian Council of Cultural Relations. Indian Council of Cultural Relations, ICCR. And the name of the competition is United Against Corona, Express Through Art. So it's a painting competition. This is won by Anjar Mustain Ali. He is from Bangladesh. Almost around $1,000, $1,000 US will be given to this particular boy. Next. Vice President Venkaiah Naidu launches virtual festival. So due to this pandemic situation, lot of festivals are being celebrated in virtual mode only. Now Vice President Venkaiah Naidu launches a virtual festival. This is Parampara Series 2020 National Festival of Music and Dance from 27th October 2020, and it was organized by Natya Tarangini, partnership with United Nations of Organization. And Natya Tarangini has been organizing the Parampara series continuously since 23 years. So this is a virtual festival launched by our Honorable Vice President Venkaiah Naidu. He is hails from Andhra Pradesh. And there is an award given to Dr. Satish Mishra. What is this award? Dr. Tulsi Das Chug Award 2020. And why did he get that award? For his research work on malaria parasites life cycle. So he worked his research on malaria's parasites life cycle. That's why he got that Dr. Tulsi Das Chug Award 2020. And who gave the award? CSIR CDRI. He's a scientist from CSIR CDRI. And who gave the award? The Council of Scientific Industrial Research gave the award to Dr. Satish Mishra for his research on malaria parasites life cycle. So that's all for today's. Hope you like the video. Please share with your friends.